question series. So the first one is, let me grab it, the sketch. Actually, should we just show the first product? Let's just show the first product. We don't need to tease anybody out here. Okay, so this is the first item that I'm going to show you in this series of blush items. So this one is called journey, and then on the next project you improve. So that's the deal. But I like it because you can wear it any kind of way. You can wear it like, I don't even know, like it's like fashion in a weird way. I wonder if you guys can see the back of it at all. I don't think you can. That's okay. Let me stand up so you guys can see the scale of it though. It's pretty crazy. It's monstrous if you ask me. seeking comfort where I will not find it. Exit the dark and enter the light where I am meant to be. So that is kind of the whole feeling of this. Another layer to it was that I was inspired by Fleetwood Mac / Stevie Nicks' song Storms. And if you guys want to give that a listen after you watch this, cool. If you want just to get a vibe for like the state of mind that I was in while listening to the song and then instantly like coming up with the idea and sketching it out. So it's just like I knew I wanted it to be this long, kind of like snaky, like huge shape. And I knew I wanted it to have a cloud and a lightning bolt on one end. And then have these like raindrop looking shapes. Comfortable storm wrapped in darkness. So then it's like a ball. Like you could ball this up and just like put it. Like there's different ways that you can display this. You can wear it as a scarf. You can wear it over your neck and have it like have some down the front, some down the back. You can lay it down flat. You can hang it on a wall like a piece of like something. Like I want my art to be versatile and fun, and it's kind of like tying with the meaning too somehow, you know. So wrapped in darkness is this mess seeking comfort in the darkness. So that's kind of like the whole inspiration of it. Like I would go to darkness and pain as a sense of like relief. Like it's weird, it's kind of like an addict mentality. Like you go back to what you know, and chemically you're hooked on something, and like psychologically you're hooked on something too. So if you grow up and you experience a lot of pain in whatever form, physical, emotional, anything, trauma, it's gonna stick with you and it's gonna implant itself into you, your brain definitely, your heart and soul, it's gonna coat it. But there's a bit of lightness still in there, so it can't completely transform you, but like it can for a while. That's like how darkness works. You're involved in it until you figure out how to get out of it and stay out of it and not be tempted by it. It's a drug. It is a addiction. It is not healthy to choose darkness and choose pain, choose suffering, choose crying every day, choosing substances, you know. Everyone has a different thing that they kind of escape to, and for me, it was like getting hurt emotionally by people, and I would stick around for it, like with friendships, like relationships, for sure. And just everything, like, I am who I am because of the pain that I've felt, and I'm not just this ball of sunshine and roses and, you know, striking beauty and, like, perfection. Like, that's not... I'm sitting on this foam mat. I take pride in who I am now, and I feel like a lot of this theme and the color scheme of everything, this dark purple, this screams like a witch to me, like a mystical figure, and like a villain almost, like villainous, strong, sexy villainous, like powerful, definitely powerful. And like that's kind of what this is to me, this whole project. It's like this empress of darkness. She has this beauty, she has this like allure to her. It's kind of like a siren. If you're familiar with that whole concept, like Greek mythology sirens, like you're encapsulated, you're like drawn in. It's like the snake in the Garden of Eden. Like the evil forces are like seducing you to like join it and like suffer with it, like gates of hell, like come on in baby, like let's go. And that's their job. That's the empress, the goddess. It's not even the empress, it's like the goddess of darkness, the goddess of evil, the goddess of all things heavy and painful. She wants you to sob, she wants you to be miserable, she wants you to suffer, because that's what makes her powerful, is her control over that. So it's kind of like this weird like archetype story that is also woven into this. So this to me is a lot. It's not just like some silly piece of like fabric. I mean, it kind of is, like from the surface. person that you were, that goddess of evil that you were, and decide to not be that anymore and to change and to follow the light. It's up to you. You get to choose which cloak you wear. You get to choose which mask you put on. Who do you want to be? Do you want to be the villain in your life, or do you want to be the hero of your own life and create something of yourself from this same place? Identities and hats that we gotta wear. So that is it for this video.